Hello students, here I want to make some lecture videos which are targeting for JEE Main 2021 and JEE Advanced 2021. So it is a first video for organic chemistry targeting JEE Main 2021 and JEE Advanced 2022. So in the first chapter of the organic chemistry, so one of the important concept, that is the hybridization. So I want to start from the hybridization. That means here first I will cover basic topic of organic chemistry, like hybridization structure, and next nomenclature and isomerism, general organic chemistry, alkanes, benzene, and immediately I will start the second year syllabus also. So in every chapter I want to discuss some most important points. Okay, so you should follow these videos one by one. I want to give a sequence of lecture videos which are very useful for JEE Main as well as JEE Advanced. Okay, so please subscribe my channel. And so first of all, here hybridization. So here in hybridization of organic compounds, so around the carbon here 4 sigma bonds are there. So here in this case, that carbon undergoes sp3 hybridization. Okay, so actually here these videos are very useful for students already who have some idea about the organic chemistry. Okay, because it's I don't want to explain from the basic points. Okay, so here just directly I want to start the topic. That means some exceptional reactions, exceptional points, so which are very useful for the examination. Okay, so first here, if carbon has a 4 sigma bonds that undergoes sp3 hybridization. Hybridization is nothing but intermixing of the atomic orbitals. So in a carbon, in first excited state that has a 4 single electrons, okay, this one undergoes sp3 hybridization. Okay, so here the carbon which has a 4 sigma bonds sp3 hybridization, and that one has a tetrahedral geometry. Here in this case, in this hybridization, 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals are generated. Okay, 4 sp3 hybrid orbital. These 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals are arranged in a tetrahedral geometry, and each one is involved in a overlapping with the hydrogen s orbital. So you'll get the CH4 tetrahedral molecule. So here we can see this is the CH4 tetrahedral molecules. Okay, so here in this case, here 4 CH bonds. So and here in this case, hydrogen, carbon, hydrogen, there is a tetrahedral angle. The tetrahedral angle is 109 degrees 28 minutes. Okay, now in this case, how many tetrahedral angles, that means so how many 109 degrees 28 minutes are possible? Okay, so here actually here 6 109 degrees 28 minute angles are possible. That means here 6 tetrahedral angles are possible. Okay, so here in this case, this is the first, this is the one angle. Okay, and this second angle, and this one is the third angle. Okay, and next year, this is the fourth angle, and this one is the fifth angle, this one is the sixth angle. Okay, so in this case, this one making a 3 angles. Okay, and next year, this is the one angle, and between these two, one angle, and between these two, one angle. So totally 6 tetrahedral angles are present in a 1 tetrahedral geometry molecule. Okay, that's it. Now here next, if a carbon has a pi bond that undergoes sp2 hybridization, because here this pi bond is not formed by the hybrid orbitals. Only sigma bonds are formed by the hybrid orbitals. Here pi bond is formed by the overlapping of the pure p orbital. So here the carbon, in the carbon, just 3 orbitals are involved in a hybridization, that is nothing but sp2 hybridization. As a result of this sp2 hybridization, 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals are generated. These 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals are arranged in a trigonal planar geometry. Okay, so with the angle of 120 degrees. Okay, this is 120 degree, this is 120 degree, this is also 120 degree. Okay, so here in this case, the remaining one p orbital, that is the unhybridized orbital on each carbon are parallel each other, so there is a pi bond formation. Okay, so here in this case, this pi bond means you can see this is the structure of the alkene. Okay, here carbon hydrogen bonds. Here in this case, this is the pi electron density. This pi electron density above the molecular plane. Molecular plane means the plane which contains carbon hydrogen bonds, that is the molecular plane. Okay, so totally this is the molecular plane. So above the molecular plane, this pi electron density, and below the molecular plane, this pi electron density is present. Okay, this is the pi electron density, and this is also pi electron density. That means here in this direction, so there is a pi electron density zero. That means there is a pi nodal plane. In this direction, there is a pi nodal plane is present, because above the molecular plane, this is the pi electron density. Below the molecular plane, there is a pi electron density. Okay, so along the molecular plane, there is no pi electron density. It's nothing but pi nodal plane. Okay, so you can say there is a pi nodal plane. Pi nodal plane means the plane along which zero pi electron density is there. Okay, now in this case here, each carbon undergoes sp2 hybridization. So this carbon has a 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals, and this carbon has a 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals. Okay, so here the totally that ethylene molecule has a 6 sp2 hybrid orbitals, and so remaining 2 p orbitals on the carbon are the unhybridized or pure atomic orbitals. Here hydrogen also pure atomic orbital. Okay, so totally in ethylene molecule, pure atomic orbitals are the 4 plus 2, that means here 6. Okay, 4 hydrogen pure atomic orbitals on each carbon, so 1 p orbital is unhybridized pure atomic orbital, so totally 6. And here sp2 hybrid orbitals are also 6. Okay, so because here each carbon has a 3 sp2 hybrid orbitals, that's it. Now here, if carbon has 2 pi bonds that undergoes sp hybridization, okay, that 2 pi bonds may be in the form of triple bond or may be in the form of 2 double bonds. Okay, so that undergoes sp hybridization. Why? Because for the formation of the 2 pi bonds, here 2 p orbitals must be unhybridized. Okay, so that means here 2 pure p orbitals are involved in a hybridization. As a result, we will get the 2 sp hybrid orbitals. These 2 sp hybrid orbitals are arranged in a linear geometry, and remaining 2 p orbitals form a pi bond. Okay, here in this case here, this bond is a sigma sp s bond. This bond also sigma sp s bond. Okay, because sp hybrid orbital of the carbon and hydrogen s orbital. Okay, so here in this case, remaining 2 p orbitals on each carbon are unhybridized, so these two are parallel each other, and these two are parallel each other, so there is a pi bond formation. So here in this case, the hydrogen carbon hydrogen, all these atoms are present in single line. That means here this one has a linear geometry with the angle 180 degrees. Okay, so esterine molecule is a linear with 180 degrees angle. And now here, how many hybrid orbitals are present? So sp carbon has 2 hybrid orbitals. Okay, so here 2 carbons, so totally 4 sp hybrid orbitals are present in this compound. Okay, how many pure atomic orbitals? Pure atomic orbitals. Okay, on each carbon 2 pure p orbitals. Okay, so 2 plus 2, and here hydrogen pure s orbital, hydrogen pure s orbital, so here also 6 pure atomic orbitals are in esterine. Okay, for suppose here pure atomic orbitals of the carbon means only 4. Okay, that's it. So generally in ethylene molecule, here bond angles are there. Okay, so why? Because this double bond occupy more space. So here this double bond, single bond, more repulsions. So your bond angle increases. That means here 121.7 degrees. Here the CH, these two are the single bonds. So here bond angle decreases. That is the 116.6 degrees. Okay, that's it. These bond angles are given in a NCERT textbook. Okay, you can check. Copy, that means in a first year textbook. Okay, so in a chapter of the alkenes. Now here, so here carbon has 4 sigma bonds sp3, 1 pi bond sp2, and 2 pi bonds sp. Okay, so here in this case, this carbon is the sp3 hybridized, this carbon is the sp3 hybridized. Okay, ethane molecule. So sp3 means here 4 hybrid orbitals. Here also sp3 means 4 hybrid orbitals. Okay, so here in this case, totally 8 hybrid orbitals are present in ethane molecule. How many pure atomic orbitals are present in ethane molecule? Just we can consider hydrogen s orbitals. Totally 6 hydrogens are there. So 6 pure atomic orbitals are present in ethane molecule. And this carbon-carbon sigma bond is formed by the sp3-sp3 hybrid orbitals overlapping. Okay, that's it. So next, this one. Here in this case, 1,3-butadiene. This 1,3-butadiene is totally planar. Why it is a planar? Because all carbons are sp2. Okay, all carbons are sp2. So here sp2, that means here one sigma, one pi bond, and that is a 3-sigma bond. So sp2 carbon, this one also sp2 carbon. This carbon is sp2, this carbon is a sp2. So totally 4 carbons are sp2. That means here each sp2 carbon has how many hybrid orbitals? 3 hybrid orbitals. So here 3, here for this one 3, for this one 3. So here 3, 3, totally here 12 hybrid orbitals are present. Okay, 12 sp2 hybrid orbitals are present in 1,3-butadiene. And how many pure atomic orbitals of the carbon? Okay, so not in the molecule. Here pure atomic orbitals of carbon. Or here sp2 means a remaining one p orbital, here also one remaining p orbital, one remaining p orbital, 4. Now here pure atomic orbitals of 1,3-butadiene totally. Okay, that means here C4H6, total pure atomic orbitals in ethyl 1,3-butadiene molecule. So here on each carbon one p orbital, and on hydrogen s pure atomic orbital. That means here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means here 4 plus 6, here 10 pure atomic orbitals. Okay, now in this case, this is a planar molecule because all carbons are sp2. So all atoms are present in the same plane. That means here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here 10 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, that's it. Next here, for suppose this one sp hybridization, this one sp, this one sp, this one sp. Because here each carbon contains 2 pi bonds, so here all carbons are sp2 hybridized carbons. So here sp means here 2 hybrid orbitals, here 2 hybrid orbitals, 2 hybrid orbitals, 2 hybrid orbitals. Totally 8 hybrid orbitals are present in this one. 1,3-butadiene. Okay, 1,3-butadiene. How many pure atomic orbitals of carbon? How many pure atomic orbitals of carbon? Here in this case, sp means here remaining 2. Here also remaining 2, here remaining 2, here remaining 2. So totally 8. Okay, so pure atomic orbitals of the carbon. Now pure atomic orbitals of the molecule. So total molecule on taken. So here you have to consider this hydrogen atoms also. So hydrogen s orbital. So 8 plus 2, 10 pure atomic orbitals in this 1,3-butadiene. Okay, now in this case, all carbons sp. So it is a linear molecule. Okay, it is a linear molecule. All atoms are present in a single line. So here linear molecule, we can say this one also planar, but all planar molecules are not linear, but all linear molecules are the planar. Okay, but suppose this is a planar molecule, but not linear, because all atoms are not present in a single line. Okay, that's it. But in this case, we can say this is a planar also, because all atoms are present in the same plane as well as same line. Okay, so next here you can see this is the sp carbon, here sp2, here sp2. Okay, so here in this case sp means linear, sp2 means planar. So here this molecule is a planar but not a linear. Okay, because all atoms are not present in a single line. That's it. Now here in this case, okay, all atoms are present in the same line, same plane. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, 8 atoms are present in the same line. And how many hybrid orbitals are present in this molecule? Sp means here 2 hybrid orbitals. Sp means 2 hybrid orbitals. Sp2 means 3. Here sp2 means 3. So totally how many hybrid orbitals? So 10 hybrid orbitals are present. Okay. So the hybrid orbitals are the sp and as well as sp2. So now here pure atomic orbitals of carbon only in this molecule. Okay. Sp means here remaining 2 p orbitals. Here sp means remaining 2. Sp2 means remaining 1. Here sp2 means remaining 1. So here 4 and here 2, 6. Okay. Now here pure atomic orbitals of the molecule. Okay. So you can check in the question. The question like they're asking number of that means pure atomic carbons of the carbon or pure atomic carbons of the molecule. Okay, so along with 6 pure atomic orbitals, here 1, 2, 3, 4 hydrogen s orbitals also considered the pure atomic orbitals. Those are involved in just overlapping with hybrid orbitals of the carbon. So here 4, 6 plus 4, here 10 pure atomic orbitals in this molecule. Okay, so next here the one more important question, that means molecule, this one. Okay, you can see here, this is the sp carbon, this is the sp carbon, this is sp3 carbon, but it is non-planar molecule. Why it is a non-planar molecule? Due to presence of the sp3 carbon, it is a non-planar molecule. Okay, so now here in this case, question is, how many atoms are present in a plane? Okay, how many atoms are present in a plane? So here in this case, you can see like this. Yes, here in this case is the this is the CH3. Okay, yes, CH3, and to this CH3 there is a carbon like this. Okay, C triple bond C. So here, sorry, this one. Okay, just wait. Yeah, so here in this case, yes. Okay, so just here this one again. Okay, this one here, CH3, yeah? Carbon, hydrogen, and hydrogen, hydrogen. So this CH3, carbon, carbon, C triple bond C. It is a triple bond actually. Okay, again to this one there is a bond also. Okay, again this one there is a bond also. Okay, so I cannot put this one here, there is no hole actually. So that's it. So now here in this molecule, how many atoms are present in the same plane? Okay, so here in this case, this one, two, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so these 5 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, like this, it is a plane actually. Okay, in this plane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means here in CH3, carbon and hydrogen, this carbon, triple bond, carbon, bond, hydrogen. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 5 atoms are present in the plane. Okay, that means here this is on the plane, this is on the plane, this is above the plane, this is below the plane. Why? Because it is a sp3 carbon tetrahedral, and this tetrahedral, 2 bonds on the plane, 1 bond above the plane, 1 bond below the plane. So your CH bond on the plane, CC bond on the plane, this totally on the plane because it is a linear actually. Okay, this part is a linear. Okay, so here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So your five atoms present in the same plane. Okay, it's a very very important question. On the sp3 carbon, 2 bonds on the plane, remaining 2, one is above the plane, one is below the plane. Okay, that's it. So next, some more molecules we'll discuss. So you see in this case, benzene. Okay, so benzene is totally planar because here all carbons are sp2, so all bonds, all atoms are present in the same plane. That means here 12 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, C6H6. Okay, so remaining 1 p orbital is involved in a pi bond formation. Okay, that's it. So sp2 planar. Now here 6, so each sp2 carbon has a 3 hybrid orbitals. So here 3 into 6, so 18 hybrid orbitals are present. Okay, 18 hybrid orbitals are present. Now pure atomic orbitals on each carbon, 1 p orbital is a pure atomic orbital, unhybridized orbital, and 6 hydrogen, so 12. Okay, okay, there you can see the questions like the ratio between the pure atomic orbitals and the hybrid orbitals, like 12 is to 18. Okay, that means in this case, so here 2 is to 3. Okay, that's it. And next here in this case, number of sigma bonds, here number of sigma bonds are the 12, and pi bonds, you know that, 3. Okay, here 6 CC bonds and 6 CH bonds, totally 12 sigma bonds. Okay, that's it. So hybrid orbitals are the 18, pure atomic orbitals are 12 for the benzene. Okay, and next here, let us take the toluene. Okay, let us take the toluene. Here this is a JE main question in a January session 2020, this year. Okay, so here in this, in the toluene, how many atoms are present in the same plane? Okay, so just we said that on the sp3 carbon two bonds on the plane. Okay, two bonds on the plane, one bond above the plane, one bond below the plane. So here in this case, so 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13, so 13 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, the sp3 carbon, of course. Okay, remaining six are the sp2 carbons, but here 13 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, so that is a so here next one more question, that is some more questions for the based on the hybridization. So here in this case, so here this carbons also sp2 hybridized carbon in benzaldehyde. This carbon also sp2 hybridized carbon. All carbons are the sp2, and here totally planar, that means here all atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, so along with these three atoms here, this carbon hydrogen atoms also present in the same plane. Okay, that means here hydrogen, 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 here hydrogen, hydrogen. So here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14, so here 14 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, that's it, and all carbons are sp2. Okay, there is a pi bond in this case. Okay, so in this case number of pi bonds are the four, so 1 2 3 4, this is the fourth one. So next here, this is the cinnamaldehyde. This is cinnamaldehyde. The cinnamaldehyde. The cinnamaldehyde again here, all carbons sp2. This is the sp2, this is the sp2, and this one also sp2. So again here all atoms are present in the same plane. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 and 14 15 16 17 and 18. So here 18 atoms are present in the same plane. Okay, because all carbons are the sp2 hybridized. Now how many pi bonds are present in this molecule? Here 3 pi bonds, here 2 pi bonds. So here, so 5 pi bonds are there. Okay, and next here also acrolein, also same thing. Here all atoms sp2 hybridized, so here all atoms are present in the same plane. Now in this case C2CN4 resembles C2H4. That means here in ethylene all hydrogens are replaced by the CN group. Okay, so N triple bond C, here N triple bond C. Okay, so sp carbon. Okay, and this is the sp2 and this is also sp2. We can calculate the pi bonds, sigma bonds, and hybrid orbitals for this one. Yes, CN twice means here cyanogen. Okay, cyanogen means here N triple bond C, C triple bond N. Okay, cyanogen. And next MIC means methyl isocyanate. Methyl isocyanate. Methyl isocyanate means here CH3 and N double bond C double bond O. Okay, methyl isocyanate. Okay, so here in this case this carbon undergoes sp hybridization. Here in this case sp3 hybridization for this nitrogen. Okay, for this nitrogen actually here one sigma bond, here second sigma bond, two sigma bonds, one lone pair. So here this one also undergoes sp2 hybridization. Okay, that's it. Now this oxygen undergoes here two lone pairs and one sigma bond, that means it also undergoes sp2 hybridization. Okay, so actually here we can give the hybridization for this nitrogen. Okay, that's it. Okay, so that is about the hybridization. Okay, thank you for watching. In next video let us discuss the structure of the alene and derivatives. Okay, please watch that.